Hello, welcome to online classes, children. Today we are going to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 5, decimals. And in this we are going to study about representation of decimals. So let us start it. The representation of a decimal number. Okay, so you can see here, children, any decimal number, it is having three parts, that is the whole number, the fractional part and the decimal point. Okay. The whole number and fractional part are separated by the decimal point. Okay. So this is how we represent our decimal number. The left side of the decimal point, that is the whole number part, and the right side of the decimal point is the fractional part. So let us see the place value of the decimal number. Okay. So you can see here, I have divided this into two parts, that is whole number and fractional part. Okay, so let us see the place values. This is the decimal point, you can see here, and the left side we are having the whole numbers. So the whole numbers are having the place value as we have learned before, that is ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000s, okay, and the values are like same 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, okay. But you can see here that right side of the decimal point, okay, we are having the place values as tens, hundredths and thousandths, okay. So tenths is represented as 1 by 10, hundredths is represented as 1 by 100, and thousand is represented as 1 by 1000. Okay, so this is the values of these places. You can see here, children, the given this rectangular box is divided into 10 equal parts. Okay, so we are seeing how tens is represented. So 10 equal parts, and the one part is shaded over here. So how we will write, or how we will represent this, the shaded part? So we will write it as 1/10. Okay. And we will represent it as 1 by 10. And it is equal to 0.1. Okay. We read it as 0.1. Similarly, we'll see for hundredths. Okay. So you can see this square box is divided into 100 equal boxes. And this one box is shaded here with blue, purple color. Okay. So how we will represent it as hundreds. Okay. So 100. Okay. We will write it as 100, and we will represent it as 1 by 100. This one shaded part is, or one colored part is represented as 1 by 100. Okay. So, and it is represented in decimal as 0.01. It is read as 0.01. Similarly, for thousands also we can do. So for thousand we will be writing 1000. Okay, 1000. And 1 by 1000 we will represent. Okay, and in decimal it will be 0.001. We'll read it as 0.001. Okay. So children, after the decimal number, it is a fractional part, I have said. Okay, so we will read it all the numbers individually, like 001. Okay, in this way we will be reading the decimal number. Let us see some questions from my practice time 1. For question number 1, write the following in words. Okay, so how this number is written in words. Okay, so it is like 5.3. Okay, we will read it as 5.3 and we write as same. Okay, so next question is 2.65. We'll read it as 2.65 and we'll write in the words like this, 2.65. Okay, let us see another one, 1.035. Okay, as we are reading, we will write it in the same way, 1.035. Okay, in words. So all the rest of the questions you can see here, children. D1, 21.534. Okay, you can see the number which is the whole number. Okay, that means towards the left of the decimal. We will read it as the whole number as we are reading, okay? Like 21, okay? But after the decimal number, what we will do? We will read the number individually, like 5, 3, 4. So this number is read as 21.534, okay? And we will write in the words like this, all right? Next is 7.85 and this is 12.5. 50 also you can write, or 12.5 is okay. Alright. So here you can see after the decimal number, okay, at the last, okay, if there is 0, that means this 0 is not having any value. Alright. So we can read it as 12.5 also. Alright. Thank you.